Controversial UK artist Damien Hirst has burnt hundreds of his artworks after selling them as NFTs, non-fungible tokens. Buyers were given a choice between the physical piece or the digital version. If they chose an NFT, the corresponding physical work was destroyed. Just under half the buyers chose the digital version. The estimated value of the burnt works is almost 20 million Australian dollars.
I think this has to be part of the process to create truly digital artworks. Is to destroy the physical artwork because the two can't exist at the same time.
Well, David Hume is the director of Banziger Hume Fine Art Consultants and joins us now. David, just go back a step for us, please. What is he doing? Why is he doing it?
Well, Damien Hirst created 10,000 original artworks with the help of his assistants back in 2016. And he made the decision that he would offer these for sale with a proviso that you couldn't have them for a year. And when you did want to take it, you could either take the original artwork, which was created, or you could take it as an NFT, a non-fungible token. So you had that choice.
Is it just a stunt?
Well, look, Damien Hirst has always been the master showman. He's been, he's kind of a, I guess, a 21st century edition of Salvador Dali. He regards this whole thing that he's doing as a performance, not just the sale of artworks.
So why is this so controversial in the art world?
Look, I think the whole thing with non-fungible tokens is a bit controversial because it's something that has been invested with by people who are interested in cryptocurrency. The NFT market grew from $82 million in 2020 to $17 billion in 2021, a growth of 21,000%. So a lot of people think of this as maybe, you know, more like a Ponzi scheme or a bubble. You know, what is it? And in the proof of time will work it out, maybe. You know, art museums have been collecting art for centuries. Museums collect NFTs now as well. But will they stand the test of time? The market is declining in NFTs. It's, you know, they're not selling as well as they were. So who knows?
I'm going to be honest, I find it all quite confusing. But the one thing I'm interested in, if you were into art, but you buy an NFT, then you're not displaying it. Isn't part of the appeal for people who buy art that other people see the art that they've bought?
I think you've got two different kinds of people, and an art collector really is somebody who wants to display the art. A cryptocurrency guy may think very differently. You know, the sale of a Beatles NFT for, what was it, close to $70 million last year was, you know, just blew everybody away.
David, it is quite confronting to see an artist burn art. But Damien Hirst is saying he isn't destroying the value of artworks but transferring it. Do you think that's true?
I mean, there was nothing for him to burn that artwork, but obviously Damien Hirst can sort of, to some extent, get over that. You can have it as an NFT, so you're not destroying the artwork forever. You're preserving it as something else. So maybe that's something, you know, to be happy about.
David, thank you very much for your time tonight. We appreciate it.
Thank you.